Okay, all my slasher flick cinephiles out there, this one's been cooked up especially for you. We all know the feeling of sitting on the couch shaking in our boots while stuffing our face with popcorn, but have you ever thought about what it would be like to be in the boots of a slasher film victim? Turns out what's happening in their brain is not too dissimilar from what's happening in yours when you're watching. Let's say you're running from an axe murderer in hot pursuit. Obviously, you're going to be in a state of crushing fear, but before we continue, let's talk about what exactly fear is. Fear is a cognitive response that alerts us in the face of serious trouble. Simply put, it results from chemical processes that gear our bodies up to get the heck out of danger. When you perceive possible danger, that sensory information is sent through your central nervous system to a region of the brain that works kind of like a switchboard called the thalamus. The thalamus then hustles the signal over the amygdala using a neurotransmitter called glutamate. Glutamate-based signaling then transmits the emergency to these two parts of the brain. When the signal reaches the periaqueductal gray, it switches you to a state of hyper-alertness and makes you startled. Then it's on to the hypothalamus, which controls your fight-or-flight response. To get you action ready, the hypothalamus tells your adrenal glands to start pumping out adrenaline, amongst other superpowered molecules. The adrenaline release gets you amped up and also makes its way down to your liver to trigger a release of glucose in your bloodstream. This offers you an extra jolt of energy, kind of like a sugar rush. Then cortisol keeps all of these processes in the fight-or-flight response up and running full speed. But let's say that these supercharged powers aren't enough to get you out of danger from the axe murderer. Well, that's a whole different story. All good slasher scenes feature a blood-curdling scream. Screams are actually a primordial automatic function of the body, and recent research suggests that we perceive screams in a completely different part of the brain than language. Unlike normal speech, screams go from your ears to the amygdala, the brain's emergency center, and can trigger a similar chemical response in listeners. It's almost as though the screamer is trying to share with you the state of their horrified brain chemistry. Obviously, that scream isn't going to magically stop the axe that's headed right for you, so what next? Pain is a feeling, but it's a little different from our sense of touch. When you're injured, sensory neurons specific to pain called nociceptors send this message up your spinal cord and into your central nervous system where it's relayed to the thalamus. The thalamus is the part of your brain that delegates your pain-related neurological responsibilities. Pain lets your body know that whatever just happened needs to not happen again. It's all about self-preservation, and you get the message. It hurts for a reason. So now you're on the floor, dead as a rock, thanks to Mr. Axe Murderer. Assuming no massive brain damage was inflicted, at this point you'd be considered clinically dead. That is, your heart's gone kaput, and you certainly aren't breathing. Your brain, on the other hand, is still working, and recent research has shown that during this period, your brain can enter into a hyper state of perceptual neural activity. Some even believe that this could be an explanation of near-death experiences. Well then, folks, once you've seen the light, it really means it's time for lights out. Soon your brain will shut down for good, and it's what's known as a biological death, the last stop on the slasher train. So think about it the next time you hear that blood-curdling scream in your favorite horror film. Once the damage is done, they might very well be lying on the ground reliving the entirety of that movie in their heads, thanks to all that near-death neural activity. Look, folks, we're big-time horror fans here at Reaction, so do us a favor and post your favorite slasher flick down in the comments. Promise we'll watch them all. And if you want to learn more about what happens to your body after you die, check this video out. And on the topic of death, here's one on poisons. Thanks for watching, folks. Make sure to subscribe and hit the thumbs up button on the way out.